Last week, legislators from Karamoja sub-region made an alarm over the alleged diversion of relief items meant for vulnerable Karamojong people by the officials in the office of the Prime Minister. They further accused these senior officials of distributing among themselves more than 12,000 iron sheets, goats, and foodstuffs that were meant to benefit these vulnerable people that have in the recent past been affected by starvation and spates of insecurity.
How can iron sheets meant for Karamoja find themselves 300 kilometers away in Bugishu, on top of the roofs of houses, when the people who are suffering there are waiting for them?
Though the Prime Minister Robin Nabanja trashed the allegations, the Inspectorate of Government, Betty Kamya, promised to investigate the scandal.
I want to assure you that we shall investigate this matter without fear or favor. And if there are people who need to step aside because we fear that they might tamper with the investigation, we shall ask them to step aside.
During a news conference today at the Uganda Media Center in Kampala, the IGG also issued a one-month ultimatum to all public servants to declare their wealth as stipulated by the law. Those who fail to comply risk dismissal from office, among other tough penalties.
Article 233 and 234 of the Constitution of Uganda and Section 4 of the Leadership Code Act require political leaders and appointed leaders specified under the second schedule, Part A, and third schedule, Part A and Part B of the Leadership Code to declare to the Inspectorate of Government their incomes, assets, and liabilities every 2 years in the month of March.
According to the director of the Leadership Code at the office of the IGG, Jerome Magezi, they have received 31 non-compliance cases to the declaration of wealth by the public servants since 2021.
After doing verifications and investigations, cases where we find the breaches, we are supposed to, among others, submit them to the Leadership Code Tribunal. It is the tribunal that tries the cases of the Leadership Code. Out of those, 10 were convicted and fined, and others cautioned. As the IGG told you, for the breaches, those are the sanctions, the fines, the cautions, the dismissals, the removal from office. Those are some of the sanctions that the Leadership Code Tribunal does. So far, as of now, we have 19 ongoing cases.
Among the public servants supposed to declare their wealth are the elected political leaders from the LC3 upwards to the president, people appointed by the president, among others. The declaration process will be digital using the IG online declaration system. Declaration of wealth by the public servants is intended to combat corruption among the government officials. Story by Juliet Namuaya for the news.